In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, God's good people, and welcome. Today is Sunday, the 31st of May, 2020. It is Pentecost Sunday. Thanks for joining us. Today, the promise is fulfilled. The Holy Spirit has been given to us. We were, as it seemed, in the upper room with Mary and the apostles, waiting for the promise of the Holy Spirit. And today, the Holy Spirit comes to us. Happy Pentecost Sunday. The Holy Spirit has been given to us. Beloved, the Holy Spirit comes with a great assignment. The Holy Spirit comes with a great task. His work is to accompany us. His work is to journey with us. The Holy Spirit is not a play tool. It's not a toy in our hands. He comes to journey with us through life, to accompany us. He has a great mission, a great task. Today, therefore, celebrating this great feast of Pentecost, all of us have received the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. But I would like us to make a distinction between having the Holy Spirit and listening to the Holy Spirit. Those are two different things. You may have the Holy Spirit, but you do not listen to the Holy Spirit. Now, what is the difference? The Holy Spirit comes as a counselor. The Holy Spirit comes as a teacher to reveal all truth to us. And so, if we listen to the Holy Spirit, we shall listen to His wise advice. We shall judge prudently and act wisely. But if you do not listen to the advice of the Holy Spirit, you will never be very right in your judgments. So though the Holy Spirit may be in you, you may not be listening to the Holy Spirit. Jesus tells us in the Gospel of John, chapter 16, verse 7 and verse 13, the Holy Spirit comes to teach us all truth. He comes to guide. He comes to lead. But if the one who leads you leads correctly, but you refuse to follow, then you see that you would lead your own self astray. So the Holy Spirit leads, but do we follow? Do we listen to His advice? That is where lies the difference. Today, therefore, the church is inviting us to be submissive, to be docile to the Holy Spirit. He has been given to us. He is there to counsel, to give good advice, to teach us, to guide us and to lead us. But if we do not listen to Him, we may have Him, but do not make good use. The second difference we need to make is between submitting to the Holy Spirit or controlling the Holy Spirit. Now, beloved, we do not control the Holy Spirit. We rather need to be submissive to the Holy Spirit. Some of us think we can pocket the Holy Spirit. Some of us think we are so full of the Holy Spirit and can command the Holy Spirit. No. The Holy Spirit rather needs to command us. He needs to take hold of us. We, on our part, need to make ourselves available for Him. To be submissive, to be humble, to be docile, so that He takes total control of us. He possesses us, and then He works through us. So it is the Holy Spirit working through us, not we working. The Holy Spirit that has been given to us, the Holy Spirit that is in us, works through us. So, beloved, there is the difference. We allow the Holy Spirit to take control of us. We do not control Him, but we allow Him to control us. We become submissive to Him. So do not pocket the Holy Spirit. Do not think only you have the Holy Spirit. Make yourself docile and the Holy Spirit will use you. The Holy Spirit is the master and we are His servants. And a servant can never be greater than his master. Now, how can we listen to the Holy Spirit? Beloved, the Holy Spirit can only be listened to when we are quiet. Compare 1 Kings chapter 4 and you will listen. And chapter 19, verses 10 to 13, the Holy Spirit comes in a gentle breeze. And when He comes in a gentle breeze, we are able to listen to Him only when we are quiet and when we keep silence. When we are noisy, beloved, amidst the hectic life and amidst the grace of this life, the Holy Spirit gives His advice. He gives His wise judgment. He gives His wise counsel. But it's difficult for us to listen to the Holy Spirit because of the noise. Therefore, we need to be quiet to listen to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit also comes to teach, to make us understand the truths that there are. And so if you are not able to understand truths, it means you are not docile to the teachings of the Holy Spirit. Beloved, these are the differences we need to make. Controlling the Holy Spirit or being submissive to the Holy Spirit. Having the Holy Spirit and listening to the Holy Spirit. These are all different. When the Holy Spirit comes, the Holy Spirit makes us to be united because it's a spirit of unity. Unity is not conformity. When we come together to do something which is evil, we are conforming. Unity is always for good. The Holy Spirit comes to make us united to do good things. The Holy Spirit comes to make me forget about myself, but think about all. About us, not me, not I. In the family, in the group, wherever I find myself, when I always think us, not me or I, then the Holy Spirit is at work. Because the Holy Spirit is a uniting factor. When we are able to forget about our differences and see each other as brothers and sisters, then the Holy Spirit is at work. Because the Holy Spirit never gives bad advice. He always gives good advice. The Holy Spirit comes to make us love because the Holy Spirit is the spirit of love. Where there is love, there is the Spirit of God. So if you have the Holy Spirit, but you cannot love, it means you do not listen. You do not allow the Holy Spirit to work in you. You stifle the Holy Spirit, as it were. The Holy Spirit sanctifies. The Holy Spirit makes holy. The Holy Spirit comes to make us holy. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, God's Spirit is on us. Galatians chapter 5, the Holy Spirit is God's mark of ownership upon us. He comes to make us holy. But if we detach ourselves from the Holy Spirit and do sin, and do things that are evil or contrary to the Holy Spirit, you see, we may have the Holy Spirit, but do not allow Him work in us. If you go all through Scripture, you find persons who had the Holy Spirit and who allowed the Holy Spirit to use them. In Acts chapter 7, verses 55 to 59, when Stephen was filled with the Holy Spirit, he was able to forgive those who persecuted him. The Holy Spirit gave him good advice to forgive those who persecuted him. That is what the Holy Spirit does. The Holy Spirit gave him good advice, taught him to forgive. In Luke chapter 4 verse 1, when Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit, he was led into the desert. Silence to pray. The Holy Spirit leads us to pray. The Holy Spirit leads us to silence. That is what the Holy Spirit comes to do, beloved. He journeys with us. He comes to journey with us. But if you do not listen to Him, if you do not allow Him to use you, you might just be wasting the gift of the Holy Spirit that has been given to you. Oh, beloved, God has given His Holy Spirit to us. Let us make good use of the Spirit. Let us see the fruits of the Spirit in your life. It is not about shouting and calling out fire and thunder. It is about love. It's about unity. It's about peace. It's about forgiveness. Then we see that in truth, you have the Holy Spirit and you are listening to Him. Because all of us have the Holy Spirit, but just how many listen to Him? Come, O Holy Spirit, and fill the hearts of thy faithful. Send forth thy Spirit, and they shall be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of your Spirit that you have poured out upon us. May we always listen to Him and journey with Him, so that He may give us good advice, and when we listen to that good advice, we may enter into that blessed kingdom you have prepared for us. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Receive the Holy Spirit and let peace be upon your lives and your families. Amen.